go right to God, and God will start downloading and speaking to you. You'll go to the Bible, he'll show you what's right, and he'll show you what's wrong. And I'm about to show you what's wrong about Christmas. I'm about to show you in so many ways. I was raised to say Merry Christmas. I was raised, hey, I got the hat on. This is one of the most beautifulest times of the year. Colors, lights, festivity, family, friends, gift giving, all of that. But it was seduction. It was put on you. It was made. If you don't even look at Christmas, you serve other gods. Spending, oh God, I got a video for you right after that. Let me get to that. I told you, I got to stay focused. I don't do this off of notes, so let me just keep my train of thought. Make this quick. I'll get back on here. I want to tell you, baby Jesus, King of Righteousness. We as Christians have to stop believing everything people tell us. Let me tell you about Christianity, and this is a different topic. It's just like slavery. Keep the body strong. You got Christians running around, working. But the mind is weak. Oh, I can't do this. Let pastor say so. Oh, I can't do this. Let this say. Oh, mother of the church. Who? Get your own mind. Put the mind of Christ on. Put on the mind of Christ, the Bible say. Not the mind of your pastor. Not the mind of your preacher, mama, teacher, none. Put on the mind of Christ. And tell your pastor to put on the mind of Christ as well. That's what we're missing, folks. Our bodies are strong. You look at the wider body of church. We run around here. Oh, we got to do this. We got to do that. We got to meet here. Got to go here. Got to do what? Better listen like Mary Magdalene. Sit down, learn how to worship and learn something. Mary and Martha. It could have been Mary Magdalene. They try to discredit Mary Magdalene too, but she has a significant role in Christ's life. Back to the people who try. Christianity is keep the body strong, weaken the mind. Make them believe all this other stuff they supposed to. Matter of fact, we're going to get into it. What a Christian supposed to do, not do. It's right in your Bible. What the Bible say do, we don't do. What the Bible say don't do, we do. I'm tired of being bamboozled, religion winked, and all the other inks and winks that come along with being blind. How is you going to prosper in life when somebody give you a religion? Truthfully, if you applying Christianity the way it's supposed to be applied, you going to find out. You get blessings here and there, but you're really not in the blessing. You're probably more walking in the curse. Yes, Deuteronomy 28:15-68, than the real blessing. So I'm just trying to just, I don't care what people say about me, how you judge me. It's going down like this. Christianity is a religion that oppresses people. True believers, true people trying to have a real relationship with God. I ain't talking about pastors manipulating you to get you to give them their money. That's how they got rich. Because if Jesus is the real reason for the season, everybody have gifts under their tree, won't they? But you got the Pope on TV talking about Jesus Pope. And all y'all supposed to be poor and running around here downtrodden and just impoverished while he rich. Now that I mentioned the Pope, let's go there. Because it's the entity of the Pope, the organization of the Vatican, that gave you this. That gave you this. The word Santa. Who is Santa? Santa is a Saint Nick, okay? Do your research. Where do saints come from? The Roman Catholic Church. If you're a Christian and you ever made it up to be a saint, please, 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 come on in here. Let me see how many miracles they tell you you got to perform, how many duties you got to do. But the Bible say you go from a sinner to a saint, but then the Romans come along and put their 2 cents in it and say, no. We're the saints. Oh, you can have that saint. I'm about to tell you what saint, Satan, saints. Satan and saints. Yes, Satan. How do you say Satan with a short sounding A? S-A-T? That's Satan. But they say they saints, right? But they say Satan. There's some, that's a root word in there somewhere. We're going to figure that word out. I was thinking about it earlier when you say saints and that Satan. It's really close. I know Santa and Satan is the same word. We're going to get to that in a minute. This saint, how you go from being a sinner to a saint, but only the Roman Catholic Church can put saint in front of their name? Who goes there? Who's making up more rules to this whole religion thing? Who's trying to keep it divided? Who's trying to keep themselves up and keep you down? You work hard in the Christian church. All the chicken dinners you cook, all the services you attend, all the songs you sing, and you can't get saint in front of your name? You can only get bishop, elder, deacon? Oh, that's a slap in the face from the Roman Catholic Church. I wouldn't take that. I'd be calling the Pope right now, talking about, look, it says in this Bible right here that you say I have a right to be a saint. How come they don't call me Saint Drew? I don't put enough time. I didn't never see the miracles, but I'm quite sure somebody through my prayer, my touch, my something, got something. They probably don't know where it came from. I probably don't know I was doing it at the time. You probably don't know you helped somebody, heal somebody, or open up somebody's blind eyes to see the truth, or open up somebody's deaf ears like Christ did to hear the truth. You don't know that. People don't come back and make reports to you like these big ministries want us to always give report and tell them, you know, if they help. There's some of us out here that don't keep track. But I know it goes down, okay? But let me tell you something. We don't have saint anything in front of our name. That's just another division of the Roman Catholics to suppress who? The Christians. Why? Why do they want to separate themselves? We say Christ is rich. They say Christ is poor. I'm enjoying this because somebody tell them a damn lie. And I know it ain't Yahweh, I know it ain't Christ, I know it ain't the Holy Spirit. So now we got the Christians and the Romans. Who religion is it? Well, that's another topic. We going on the name of sin. See, I tell you, I get so carried away. But I really got, we got some stuff to talk about here. No plain patty cake no more, ain't no ooh, 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 who's my friend on Facebook. I wouldn't care less because God wants me to get this out here. I have to stay focused and get it out here. I believe I'm saving somebody's life. Oh, that's what God says. If we humble ourselves, my people who call by his name, we don't even want to believe we the people called by his name, and we don't want to humble ourselves. We keep wanting to enjoy Santa. His name is Saint Nick. Do the research. He come from the Roman Empire. Let me tell you something. All of y'all last night spent millions of dollars going around the world to see where the hell Santa Claus is. Did he come to your damn house and down your chimney? Stop with the damn lies. You going around here fornicating these people's minds with bullcrap. I'm 50 years old. I ain't never seen a Santa Claus show up nowhere I ever lived. And you haven't either. But we buy this. We buy into this and we go along with it. Nip it in the bud. It ain't real. It's not your truth. Okay. You put damn cookies and milk out for them. I know. I did it for my grandkids, but they will know the truth by next year. I didn't want to take it from them, but we all live together. So I have to just sit here and not go along with it. I speak my truth. Okay, we're going to do it, and I'm going to do it this far, but I'm not. I had to go out and take this down. I'm not going to embog my grandkids' minds with deception to the point where they saying Santa stops here. And when you look at the word Santa, if you switch the N behind the A, it say Satan. I'm not playing with you people. I told you, the Roman Catholic Church went out their way. First it started with the Greeks, then I believe they beat the Greeks up and took over Greece too, because Greece ain't got no power like it had back then. And I'm going to tell you how Greece had power. They was the ones who tried to get the children of Israel to first eat pork, even before you came to slavery. There's a man named Eleazar. Read the second book of Maccabees, Maccabees 2. You know how you say 1 Thessalonians, 1 Corinthians, 2 Maccabees chapter 6. This is about you people. This is about us. This is about God's people. Before you got into slavery, they was trying to enslave you with pork. LEAs are